With this system, we're able to do two things at once. We get the combine in the field in the fall, we're getting our crops in, and we're simultaneously seeding our cover crops. Two jobs done at one time. It's a beautiful thing.
We don't have the best land in the county. We don't have the biggest fields in the county. So how do we make our investments count?
I began to realize that we were poor investors because we weren't treating our land like we wanted it to give back to us.
Those acres that were less productive, they're the ones we wouldn't go back and cover crop because we had other priorities during harvest season.
And along the way, we thought we were going to starve to death. When you don't know if you're going to pay your bills, you don't know if you can come home to your wife and say that you're not wasting your time.
So for us, it was purely economics. For this light bulb moment we had,
why can't we just dump seed on the spinner? Well, I don't know who said it first, but the other one was like, yes, that's it.
You know? Everybody has always said that a combine was the best planter out there for weeds, because you mow one weed, you find it 15 fields later. That is the eureka moment. Yeah. It does this really well, actually. I ended up pretty much scrapping around the farm to find stuff to cobble together into this very ugly first prototype that worked. It was like, holy cow, why haven't we done this before?
Fast forward to the day, we have an entirely different system, but it's the same principle. And we load it from the ground with a gas-powered seed vacuum.
Basically, you've got a hopper. We're injecting seed into the chaff stream as it's leaving the combine. So all that seed is getting mulched in with the chaff. It's blanketed in, it's retaining moisture, it's helping germination. A new precision planting rep got really excited about rewriting a whole new set of software for us.
As we're going through the field, we're getting all of our information up front in our crop fields. At the same time, the amount of seed going out the back. So we got two sets of data in one location.
We have the ability to write prescription rates, pounds per acre applied of cover crop, based on topography of field.
It was really exciting. You know, we need more cover crops. And this gave us an opportunity to be as early as possible.
The blacks put their heads together and they were like, okay, well, maybe we can't get back into the field, but do we need to get back into the field? We thought, you know, we can collect data on it.
We're partnered with Virginia Tech and Sustainable Chesapeake on a research study.
This was best case scenario because it rained right after we early seeded. It might not be this good every year, but it's definitely good this year.
So,
what?
These are nodules, nitrogen fixing nodules that occur naturally on a vetch plant. They pull nitrogen out of the atmosphere and turn it into a usable plant available form of nitrogen where you can effectively reduce some of our fertility applications.
So I'll be interested to see next year and the different data collections what actually settles out in the end. But so far we have promising data that this is comparable to drill, if not better in some instances.
When you're in the combine in the fall, you can tell the difference in the volume of yield. It's on display on the yield monitor. 20 bushels to the acre, it's a huge difference. And now when I know I have a good established set of cover crops, I feel more confident about that yield. I know we've got protection from water loss. I know we've got protection from disease, weed, insect, pest cycles. And all that transfers to better yields at the end of the year and more money in your farmer's pocket and less runoff. You don't wash your fertilizer, go down through the woods 100 yards. I can almost arbitrarily reduce fertilizer rates. That's money.
This does make things easier. And if that's what someone needs to get into the cover cropping world, then it could do a lot of good.
Cover crops for soil health is the next big frontier.
We'll be really excited to see other people get on board with intensive cover crop management, treat it like it's an actual cash crop because it is cash to your dirt in your pocket.
I'm not going to tell you that we're out of the woods, that we've made it, but the difference is I know we're going to be all right. When you know, you know. And when you're doing the right things, you feel it. And when you can start coming home knowing that you're actually achieving what you always wanted to do, and you're able to make ends meet and join with people and have good relationships and not feel like you're failing, it's a feeling of pride that I would never be able to explain to anybody.